Megan here from MeganMins.com, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to deliver a free download, lead magnet, or content upgrade to people who opt in to your email list using ConvertKit forms or landing pages. Okay, so I wanna keep this tutorial really simple, quick, and easy for you, so I'm gonna jump right in. I wanna go ahead and let you know really quick though, if you don't have a ConvertKit account yet and you would like to sign up for a free trial, make sure you go to MeganMins.com/ConvertKit and you will see this beautiful page and you will be able to get your first month for free by clicking this button, entering in your information, and setting up your account. The normal free trial is only 14 days, so if you want an extra half of the month, then be sure to opt in through this page. And again, that's MeganMins.com/ConvertKit. Okay, now it's tech tutorial time, which means these blue light blockers are going on. I've got my red wine. I'm ready to do some tech. So let's jump in. Okay, so I'm gonna show you how to do this in two different ways, and they are very similar, which is beautiful. So I am just in the back end of ConvertKit, and we are going to deliver this free download, also known as a lead magnet or a content upgrade, through forms. So make sure you go into your ConvertKit account and click forms, then jet over here to the right corner and click new form. Now ConvertKit gives you two options, both a opt-in form, which gets embedded onto a website that you host, or a landing page, which is actually hosted by ConvertKit. I'm going to focus on showing you the form, and then I'll quickly jump over to a landing page and show you exactly how to do the same thing. Both are great options, just depending on where you're at and what options you have. So let's dig into the form. You can choose to do an inline form where it just appears in the body of a website. You can have it pop up, which is a modal option, or you can have it slide in. All of these are great, and the actual delivery of the content upgrade or lead magnet will be the same regardless of what you choose. So for this purpose, I'm gonna pick inline. And again, the delivery of the free download will actually not change based on what template we choose. So pick whatever template serves you the best. And now it's time. Now, I'm not even gonna dig into the nitty-gritty of all of the features of the ConvertKit form. They're powerful, but I wanna keep this super short and sweet, so let's jump over straight to how you deliver a free download through a ConvertKit form. Over here on the right side, we see this blue navigation, and the first thing I want you to jump over to is this email icon. This is called the incentive email. So what ConvertKit does is that when someone opts into the opt-in form, you can turn this off, but for our purposes, we need it turned on. ConvertKit will send them an incentive email after they've entered in their information. Now, this incentive email can serve a few different purposes. If you are doing double opt-in, the incentive email is how you will get the double opt-in from your new subscribers, and that is where they will click the button and they will be confirmed when they click the button in the email. If you're not familiar with a double opt-ins, and if you want to do that, there are plenty of resources about that within ConvertKit's knowledge base and on the internet, but I just wanted to make sure you knew that you do need to have the incentive email turned on in order to deliver this free download. So that button has got to be checked. And the incentive email is how we're delivering this freebie. Because in the incentive email, there's a beautiful button, and I'll show you how to edit it in just a second. But what's going to happen is when they click that button, it will either send them to a URL or a download. And actually, depending on what your freebie is, you might want to do either of those, but most of you will probably be using the download feature. So literally what you're going to do is come down here and either drop in the URL of the place where they are accessing the file, or click download and choose a file to upload. And so this should be your free download, your lead magnet, the PDF, the image, whatever it is, make sure you choose that file now. So I'm uploading the PDF. You can see how it's doing. Make sure it uploads all the way. And there we go, it's uploaded. So let's go ahead and press save. Always want to get in the habit of pressing save. And now we can go ahead and edit the email contents. So when we click this button, you'll see this pops up. This is just the incentive email that is sent to new subscribers to this form. And we have a few options. We can change what email address this comes from. It will automatically select the default email address you have chosen in your account settings. You can change the subject line and you can change the message. So the subject line, make sure it makes sense for you. So if you are doing a free download, which you are, sometimes I like to do, you know, open this to download your free daily planner. You could do like important, you know, anything like that, whatever subject line you think will be the most impactful. It is generally helpful to make sure they know that they need to open it in order to do something or get something. Then we can change our message. Now, I don't know why they make this so small. I always love using these little, I don't know what you call these three little lines, these two lines to just make this a little bigger, make it easier to read. Now, there's basically three sections of the message. There's the part before the button, there's the button, and then there's after the button. So it's not a rich text editor. It will take HTML. If you do know HTML and want to add that in, you can do that, but it is very simple. So if you want to customize this message, you would just say, hi there. Thanks so much. You know, of course, make this your language, but thanks for signing up. Click the link. I'll say click the button below to confirm your subscription and download your free daily planner. So you can change the text of this button by clicking it and saying confirm and download now. Now, if you're not using this to get double opt-in and you're just using it to send the free, you could literally just say download the free daily planner, whatever makes the most sense to you, and then change your sign off. So it can be whatever you want. And let's press the X and then let's make sure we save. Now, I don't know if you saw in that email, but it was a blue button and that button will basically just match the subscribe button. So if you want that button in your email to be orange, then the subscribe button needs to be orange. So just keep that in mind and let's do that so we can test it. Let's go ahead and make this orange. Save. And let's double check. It won't show the color in the preview, but we've edited our email. We've downloaded the PDF, so we're good to go. So let's go ahead and preview what this will look like. Now, we can't exactly test this until we embed it on our website. So I'm going to jump over to my Squarespace page and show you how to embed this. Okay, so now I'm in the back of my Squarespace site, and I'm going to go ahead and add in a new content block, or I'm sorry, a code block. Now, make sure you have access to the code block. And this is what pops up. We can add a lot of different stuff in here. We are going to jump over right now back to ConvertKit. We need to click out of preview mode and we want to go ahead and save. And let's go ahead and click embed. Now we have a lot of different options here. I think ConvertKit does a great job in their knowledge base of explaining all of the different options. You are going to want to use JavaScript and you're going to place this wherever you want this form to appear. The beauty of using JavaScript is that it will update. So you can embed this on your form and then change the text, change the fields, change the color, and it will automatically reflect wherever this code is embedded. If you're doing something like HTML, all of the design and data of this form is built into this code. So if you change something in ConvertKit, it will not be reflected wherever you embedded this. So I do recommend JavaScript. We can just come over here and click copy, jump back over to Squarespace and paste, click apply, save, and you can't view JavaScript on the backend in preview mode. So let's jump over to what this page actually looks like. Okay, so this is what it looks like. So I'm going to go ahead and have us demo and like demonstrate what this looks like and make sure the delivery was set up correctly. So let's go ahead and type in our name. And they're gonna click subscribe. Now we see their thank you message. So let's jump over to Gmail and see what this looks like. Okay, so this is what it looks like on the back end. So our subject line is here. We can see the message we put in at the beginning, the button to download, and our sign off message. So let's go and click this button. And we can see our free file opens up in a new tab. They have the opportunity to download it or print it. And we can see exactly what we wanted. So we have now delivered our free download using a ConvertKit form and we've tested it and now we know it works. So that is how you deliver a free download, a lead magnet, a content upgrade using a ConvertKit opt-in form. Now, the process is very, very similar, but I just want to quickly show you what it would look like if you were doing a landing page. So let's just jump over and do a landing page. ConvertKit just released, as of the time of this recording a few weeks ago, a bunch of new templates, which is great. So feel free to look through their library of templates and choose the landing page that makes the most sense for you and for delivering a freebie. It might be something really simple, or maybe you want something that shows a little bit of a mock-up. So just choose what works for you. I'm actually going to just choose this one because why not? Okay, so even though we have a lot of new design options, the actual delivery side is the exact same. So I'm not going to walk you through the design side of the landing page right now, but I do want to walk you through the setup, even though it's the exact same. We're going to come into the incentive email. We're going to say, you know, download now, make whatever changes we want. I'm just doing this so that we can see it come through. And let's go ahead and upload that download again. Perfect. And for funsies, let's go ahead and just update this background color. Let's go blue. Why not? Okay, so instead of embedding this on our own website, since it's a landing page, it has its own page. It's hosted by ConvertKit. So let's go ahead and open this in a new tab and we will test it out. Okay, so we can see here's our headline. Great, let's type in our email address. We're getting the success message and let's jump back over to Gmail, make sure it worked. Okay, here we go. We've got the email, we've got the blue button. If I click this button, the daily planner should open again in a new tab, and it did. So there we go. That is how you deliver a free download, a free content upgrade, or a freebie of any kind through ConvertKit forms and ConvertKit landing pages. I hope you found this tutorial really simple and easy and helpful. And again, if you're looking for a free trial of ConvertKit, be sure to go to meganmins.com/ConvertKit. And be sure to check out any of the links beneath this video because I will be sure to link to any other blog posts, videos, webinar or webinar replays, and anything and everything like that that might help you around ConvertKit. So be sure to check that out and I'll see you in the next video. I just need to create a new content